It's kind of like a plastic sheet.
Yes.
The most important part, it's like a cone, almost like a funnel that basically drains or collects the blood so you can measure the amount of blood a woman is losing.
The results were just amazing. We had thought we would achieve a 25% reduction in severe postpartum hemorrhage, which is 1 liter of blood loss. But what we found was 60% reduction.
60%?
60.
People fixing the world.
I'm Myra, Anubi, and this is People Fixing the World from the BBC World Service, a program that focuses on innovative things people are doing to make our world a better place. This week, we're talking about maternal healthcare. Now, a World Health Organization report shows that around 14 million women around the world have suffered from postpartum hemorrhage. Now, just to explain, this is when a woman bleeds excessively after childbirth. It's a big issue. Around 70,000 women die every year from this, and most of these women are in developing countries. It's actually the leading cause of maternal death. And the worst part is, in many cases, it's preventable. However, a simple solution seems to be making a big difference in Africa. And to find out more about this, I want to take you to a country that's near and dear to me, one where I gave birth as well, Kenya, specifically to the capital city, to speak to a woman who's been championing this idea in different places. Her name is Professor Zahida Qureshi. Now, she's an associate professor at the Department of Obstetrics and Gynaecology at the University of Nairobi, and she joins me from back home. Zahida, it's so nice to be able to speak to someone from home, nyumbani, as we would say. Welcome.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure to talk to you today.
Now, just help me understand why this is such an issue, postpartum hemorrhage or PPH.
So as we've heard, you know, this is a major problem globally, but most of the problem is in low and middle income countries and in developing countries such as sub-Saharan Africa. So it's the case because maybe we do not have, you know, the number of healthcare workers taking care of women. It's not a one-to-one, so women will be delivering. There won't be, you know, like one healthcare worker will be taking care of several women. Or due to the nutritional status of the woman, she may have anemia, she may have had many pregnancies, you know, so her nutritional status, her iron levels are low. And as you have more and more deliveries, the uterus, you know, it becomes a little like it doesn't contract as much as it should. So postpartum hemorrhage is, yes, excessive bleeding. And we normally say up to 500 ml of blood loss after a woman delivers is manageable. But if it goes over that, then we have postpartum hemorrhage and call it postpartum hemorrhage. And if she bleeds more than that, more than a liter, then it's severe postpartum hemorrhage. So the trial which we did in four countries, ourselves, South Africa, Tanzania, and Nigeria, in about 80 facilities, was to diagnose postpartum hemorrhage early, which was to estimate blood loss. So now what was happening traditionally, a woman would deliver, there would be blood, you know, around her perineum.
Yes, yes.
And we would just look at it and say, oh, I think this looks like 200 ml or this looks like 400, you know, just a visual estimation.
So many actually doctors, nurses, midwives, they can't really estimate currently how much blood a woman is losing.
Most of the time it's just like looking at something and saying, okay, I think this looks like 200, this looks like. So what,
but
if we were to be talking in Swahili?
Yeah.
Macho meter, so that's the macho meter, okay?
Macho so macho meter. In this case so, is eyes, so you're using your eyes as a meter to assess.
To estimate.
But it's hard to be accurate in such a situation,
and
that can actually cost someone's life.
So that is the main reason that now we felt that it's usually the estimation which is incorrect. So the trial that now we think is the game changer is when we used a plastic drape to put under the buttocks of the woman as soon as she's delivered the baby. So all the blood after that for the first 1 hour goes into this plastic drape.
I have one here. It's kind of like a plastic sheet, right?
Yes.
But the most important part, is what hopefully everyone can see down here. It's like a cone, almost like a funnel that you know, that basically drains or collects the blood. And then it's calibrated here. So you can measure the amount of blood a woman is losing.
Yes, exactly. So the blue part of it, which is the top, is what you would put under the buttocks of the woman as soon as the baby is born. And then the pouch, you roll it out and the blood drains into it. And we keep it there for 1 hour.
And is 1 hour enough to assess how much blood a woman is losing?
So usually the first hour is what is the most important, because if the uterus has contracted, if there is any tear, we've actually just stitched it, sutured it. So by the 1 hour, everything should be okay. But if she's continuing to bleed, and we have done a whole lot of interventions, and she's still bleeding, then we will monitor her for another 1 hour. But by that time, if really things are not in control, then we would have even said, okay, you know, we've done everything we need to. Now maybe we have to take her to the operating theater to do whatever additional we need to do.
Tell me a bit more about the study and the kind of impact you saw from using these drapes.
The results were just amazing, because we had thought we would achieve a 25% reduction in severe postpartum hemorrhage, which is 1 liter of blood loss, or death, or the woman having to go into theater for surgery. But what we found was 60% reduction. 60%.
60%.
60.
I can tell I can tell how happy you are with the number. Yeah. It's a big number, because it's not just about detecting early. Yeah. It's about potentially saving lives.
Yes. So this was the game changer. That yes, this drape, together with all the interventions, is what has made this big difference.
And just to be clear here, these plastic drapes, they're not preventing the hemorrhage. They're just enabling you to actually detect it early enough.
Yes, but we do have interventions that we do to prevent postpartum hemorrhage. Mm. So as soon as a woman delivers the baby, we remove the baby, and then we give a medicine to the mother, a uterotonic, we call it. A uterotonic is a drug to sort of contract or tighten the uterus, because that's where she'll bleed from. So we give that medicine to, that's the first thing we do. Within 1 minute of delivery of the baby. We can't give it when the baby is still there, because...
Yeah, it's like closing the door before the baby is out. Yeah,
before it's out. Mm-hmm. So once you've given that, then the next step is, yes, the measurement of the blood loss. Because, yes, a lot of the times the bleeding will already have been reduced because of the medicine that we've been given. We are giving to the woman. But now the next step is to measure the blood loss. Yes.
And how many times can you use the one bag on the, is it used repeatedly or is it just one woman at a time?
So the one that we have right now is a one-time use. So you put it, you dispose it, it's like done. But then the manufacturer here working with us also came up with something innovative. So the bottom part, which goes under the buttocks of the women, is something that is reusable, and that can be used 100 times. So, you know, it reduces the cost, but of course you have to take it through the cleaning process each time. And the lower part, the pouch, is like now just that little bit there, which is the disposable.
How expensive is this really? Because sometimes when you hear about these new ideas and inventions, it comes at a price. How expensive is this?
So if you talk of just the drape, it's going to cost about 200 shillings, which is like what, $1.50?
Within the Kenyan context and within hospitals specifically, is that expensive or is that cheap?
It's reasonably cheap. So, you know, if you calculate the 200 shillings you'll use on this patient and you'll save her from having a postpartum hemorrhage, all the things that you'll need to do, I mean, it's nothing. So it's really, really worthwhile. The good thing that happened is soon after the results were announced, we had a lot of support from the funder, which said we are going to supply those drapes to all the facilities that
and
participated.
Who was funding this?
the Gates Foundation.
The
next good thing that happened, and there are several good things that happened, very exciting things. There was this big momentum globally, because WHO had come in by that time to release a document called the Roadmap to Postpartum Hemorrhage Reduction. So in Kenya, I'm really happy to report that our Ministry of Health took this up very, very quickly. So we had, together with partners, they could now change the guidelines, you know, how things are done.
Zahida, you've been in this space for a long time. How would it feel, or does it feel, when you see women who die from a preventable cause?
So, you know, I once had somebody say to me, my profession as a gynecologist obstetrician is the best out of all the medical, you know, fields. And I thought about it for a moment and I said, yeah, it is, because, you know, we take care of women when they're pregnant, they have a baby. It's just such a joyous occasion. So yes, you know, out of, you know, medicine, surgery, obstetrics is the best. That's a happy one. But then I thought about it for a moment and I said, on the opposite end is the extreme of a maternal death. And maternal death is the most painful thing to happen. Yeah, just the thought of a woman who came in to deliver a baby, healthy woman, and now she's no longer alive. So that is painful from whatever cause, whether preventable, non-preventable. And even it wasn't preventable at a tertiary hospital because she'd gone through several, it was always preventable somewhere along the line, you know?
It really warms my heart to see you so excited about change and actually finding solutions. And I think that's a lot of what this program is about. So thank you so much for sharing what you have with us today.
It's been my pleasure. Thank you very much.